everyone. I'm going to be doing a tutorial today on the Crafter's Companion and Velo Box. I'm going to be doing a tutorial on how to make an A2 Velo Box. This is the Velo Box created by Crafter's Companion, and this is a little bit of a guide here that shows you photo step by steps and actually gives you dimensions on how to create your Velo Box. And this is just an 8.5 by 11 craft cardstock. My lighting is a little bit off, but I'm going to go ahead and cut it right now to 8.5 inch square. So I'm only going to have to cut the 11 inch side down to 8.5 inches because the other side, of course, is already 8.5 inches. So there's my 8.5 inch square craft cardstock. I'm going to take my Velo Box Creator and position it so you can see how I'm going to use it in order to score the lines to create an Velo Box for that would fit an A2 card. An A2 card is 4.25 by 5.5 inches, and I'm going to be creating an Velo Box that is 1/2 inch deep. So here, I'm just going to make sure I'm following directions correctly. For 1/2 inch deep, my cardstock is cut to 8.5 inch square, and I line it up first on the first arrow notch there. I score at the letter F. I move it up to the next notch, and I score again at the letter F. I turn it 180 degrees to the opposite side and score again at F at the first notch, move it up to the second notch, which creates my 1/2 inch depth, and score at F. Now that I have those sides done, I'm going to score the opposing sides at the letter H. Again, one time at the first notch and then second time at the next notch to get that 1/2 inch depth. You have to score twice and you have to move that cardstock up a step in order to get that 1/2 inch depth. For the Velo Box Creator, you can create Velo Boxes pretty much any size. You just need to make sure you have paper that will accommodate the size cards you need to make. So some of cards you might need to make, this is my bone folder here. I know this looks really crazy, but it's broken and I really like it, so I kept it. Crafter's Companion has their own scoring tool. Here's one here. I do have one, but I just really love my old bone folder. I'm just going to cut the notch out here at the corners, all the corners, and I'll just watch you here. But as I was saying, you can create an Velo Box for any size card. What you have to do is follow the directions so you can score it. What I recommend doing is using just regular printer paper to practice on, because I had to practice a few times to make sure I got this correctly before I showed you and actually made Velo Boxes for some of my cards. So once you cut the notches out, it looks sort of like this. What you can do at this point is you can stamp on it. You could maybe emboss it. You can do all sorts of things at that point because this is a pretty much a finished template of what it will be. What I like to do at this point is go ahead and fold all the score lines. This just makes it easier when I'm actually assembling it that it will fold a little bit easier. Okay, so the Velo Box Creator, you can even make flat envelopes. So you don't have to make the ones that have a dimension, but you can also make flat ones, and they can be up to, I forget how many inches they could be up to, but it's about, this is 1/2 inch, I think it can go up to maybe 1 inch. I'm just going to cut here the top part there. You don't have to do that, but I decided to cut that off so I won't have that point. You can pretty much do whatever you want. I'm just going to put some score tape here on the bottom edges, and that would allow me to have a strong hold to affix the flaps. Because when you're sending this to the mail or you're giving it to somebody, you don't want your Velo Box to open up. So I really strongly recommend using the best adhesive that you can find. So the cool thing about the Velo Box Creator is that you can create these envelopes that will fit your dimensional cards, your cards that have a lot of bulk, that have a lot of cardstock layers, and even something like ribbon, so and bows. So I really like this idea. I'm sure there are templates out there that you don't have to get the Envelobox Creator, but this makes it so much easier because you can create an envelope box for any of your card sizes. So it's not just, you don't have to sit there and figure out, how to cut or how to where to score for each size. This is just something that I had the Ultimate Crafter's Companion for years, and I happened to think about, oh, I wonder if they came out with something else, and they had the Envelobox Creator. I'm pretty sure it's been out for a while, but I decided to get it now because I thought this would be great to share on how to send those bulky cards. That a lot I get a lot of questions on how I send bulky cards. So here's yet another solution. Okay, so here's my Envelobox all done. I'm just going to now show you here. Here's a card that I made. It has some dimension here and how it fits. And this card has a little bit of an overhang. It fits in here, but it's a little bit, comes out just a little bit, but it fits. See that overhang there of that chipboard flower? See, it comes off about a half an inch. It still fits in there and it folds, but just slightly. It's not as neat as it could be. Just to show, here's another card. Here's the card that I made on Friday, and it has a little bit of an overhang of my felt flower there, but it has a big bow. So I wanted to show you how it fits in here, and so how you can see if the felt flower will mess up. And here's another card I'll show you that just has a bow, no overhang at all. And if you just slide it in there, your bow might get smushed. So you have to be careful when you actually place your card in the Envelobox first to make sure it ships accordingly. As you can see here, you have a lot of space on the inside. If you wanted to, you can go up, like I said, and you can do a 3/4 inch. And I could also change the size of my box to make it larger to accommodate any overhang. So this just gives you an idea of how much space is on the inside and how it is gives you a lot more space than your typical flat envelopes that you find on the market out there. And what's really cool is that I use Paper Tray Inks cardstock, and so it's very, very sturdy. It's much more sturdier than your regular envelopes that you find on the market, and it's really almost like a box. So here's my Envelobox, my A2 size. I hope you like this today's tutorial. Thanks so much for watching. Guys, have a great Wednesday. Bye.